Here's something from Norman Mailer. At one point, he was talking about, we were talking about violence, and he said, what I still disapprove of is inhuman violence, violence which is on a large scale and abstract. I disapprove of bombing a city. I disapprove of the kind of man who will derive aesthetic satisfaction from the fact that an Ethiopian village looks like a red rose at the moment the bombs are exploding. I won't disapprove of the act of perception which witnesses that. I think that act of perception is, I'm going to use the word again, noble. What I'm getting at is a native village is bombed and the bombs happen to be beautiful when they land. In fact, it would be odd if all that sudden destruction did not liberate some beauty. The form a bomb takes in this explosion may be in part a picture of the potentialities it destroyed. So let us accept the idea that the bomb is beautiful. If so, any liberal who decries the act of bombing is totalitarian if he doesn't admit as well that the bombs were indeed beautiful. So he said, think of a young pilot who comes along later, some young pilot who goes out on a mission and isn't prepared for the fact that a bombing might be beautiful. He could conceivably be an idealist. There were some in the war against fascism. If the pilot is totally unprepared, he might never get over the fact that he was particularly thrilled by the beauty of that bomb. Okay, so then later, at one point, I'm saying to him, is it possible that you have a totalitarian attitude toward masturbation? Mailer, I wouldn't say all people who masturbate are evil. Probably I would even say that some of the best people in the world masturbate. But I am saying it's a miserable activity. Question, well, we're getting right back now to this notion of absolutes. You know, to somebody, masturbation can be a thing of beauty. Mailer, to what end? To what end? Who is going to benefit from it? Question, it's a better end than the beauty of a bombing. Mailer, masturbation is bombing. It's bombing oneself. Question, I see nothing wrong if the only person hurt from masturbation is the one who practices it. But it can also benefit. Look, Wilhelm Steckel wrote a book on autoeroticism, and one of the points he made was that at least it saved some people who might otherwise go out and commit rape. He was talking about extremes, but... Mailer, it's better to commit rape than masturbate. Maybe. See, he heard himself speak and he realized perhaps he'd better modify that. The whole thing becomes difficult. Question, but rape involves somebody else. The minute you, Mailer, just talking about it on the basis of violence, one is violence toward oneself, one is violence toward others. And you don't recognize, let's follow your argument and be speculative for a moment. If everyone becomes violent toward themselves, then past a certain point, the entire race commits suicide. But if everyone becomes violent toward everyone else, you would probably have one wounded hero monster left. Question, and he'd have to masturbate. Mailer, that's true, but you use that to point out how tragic was my solution, which is that he wins and still has to masturbate. I replied that at least it was more valuable than masturbating in the first place. Besides, he might have no desire to masturbate. He might lie down and send his thoughts back to the root of his being.